of basar b'chalav. One of the things we said in the introduction is that basar b'chalav and also filet kerem is different than other things because those things the Torah did not say the words lo tochelu, lo yachel, which means the Torah doesn't forbid you from eating it. The Torah speaks on a different language, and the Torah says lo tevashel gidi b'chalav imon. From there you learn that you're not allowed to eat it. So therefore the Rambam writes that it's assumed to eat even shelo bederech achilato, and even if it doesn't have a good taste into it, or the way you're eating it is not on a natural way. Normally, in any other things, we explain that if you're eating it not regularly, the way you would benefit from the food, you would not be forbidden min haTorah, only min haRabbanan, because it's called achshaveh, you give it an importance of food. But otherwise, it's not considered davar that's chashuv. If you're not eating it for the purpose of food, and therefore the example to that we gave is like medicine. You take it for medicine purposes. Sometimes it will be allowed if it doesn't taste well. That's how many of the poskim bring down halacha lemaaseh. So therefore, if you have basar bechalav, you would normally be like anything else. That if you eat it while it's a little bit spoiled, it should be mutar. But since the Torah didn't say over here the words of lo tochelu, lo yachel, so therefore, over here says the Rambam that it's asur even if you're eating it without benefiting from it. And we wanted to go so much to explain that could be that's what the reason. Also ashes, when you burn the basar b'chalav, ashes should also be asur. Unlike the ashes, for instance, of Chametz v'Pesach or any other ashes of davar that's asur be'ana, because right now it's not there anymore. But over here, the Torah would still forbid it. Some learn that it's the Oraita. Some learn that it's the Rabbanan, that it should be asur, the ashes. But however you're going to learn it, it's asur. And therefore you need to burn bury it and not burn it. By the way, throw it into the toilet is the same as burning it. It's the same as getting rid of it. So therefore, we had the question over here asked, that why is it that we found that noten tam lifgam is mutar? We're just saying right now that it's asur, whether you benefiting from it or you're not benefiting from it, right? So the answer to that question is the following. If you have, and this is written in few places, in the Kreti, in the Prime Gadim, he brings down in the Hakdama, he says the following. He says, basar bechalav, it depends how it's made. If you take basar and you make it basar bechalav, which means you take meat and milk together and you cook them together, that right now you have basar bechalav mideoraita, so he writes over there that it would be asur even if it becomes very spoiled. According to that, you make ashes out of it, it was basar bechalav originally, you're not allowed to benefit from it. Although it's noten tam lefgam, and way more than just noten tam lefgam. The only noten tam lefgam that would be mutar in basar bechalav is if they're not yet basar bechalav. You have, for instance, a pot that had in it milk, and right now it's left 24 hours without cooking milk in it, so it's noten tam lefgam. If you cook meat in it, so it's not asur that meat, because it never became a basar bechalav yet.
Was it milk hot?
The milk, let's say, was hot in the pot. You cooked
meat.
Might be
a problem then.
I'm sorry?
There might be a problem.
1 minute. The idea is like this. You had over here a pot, and you used that pot to warm up milk. So the pot became milk pot. And you waited 24 hours. You cleaned that pot, you put it away, 24 hours afterwards, that pot becomes eino ben yomo, it's noten tam lifgam, and therefore, you're not allowed lechatchila to use it with meat, because it's a gzera of chazal, eino ben yomo, atu ben yomo, as we're going to see in Siman Tzadik Gimel. But if you used it, well, you weren't allowed, you used it, so therefore, the meat would be mutar. Why? Because the milk in it is noten tam lefgam. You'll have to do now a gala on the pot. Why? Because it's a milchik pot, and you cooked in it meat. But the meat itself would be mutar. That is mutar because it's not en tam lifgam, as we explained. But if you made already meat and milk together, let's say you cooked meat in milk, so therefore that meat and the milk as well will be asur even if they're not en tam lifgam, which means, let's say the meat already spoiled, very spoiled, it's completely rotten already, you're still not allowed to have that because the Torah never said don't eat it. The Torah only said a different word, and the Rambam learns that according to that, it would be asur even shelo kederech hana. Good? Yes.
So if you cook in this in the pot,
yes,
milk and meat, and next day you cook something else, whatever is in the pot, it's still not en tam lifgam. It's now not en tam lifgam.
So if you cooked meat and milk together,
together,
right? So we're going to learn that later on, but to answer your question, this pot becomes davar asur. It becomes a asur pot. And therefore, if you cook 24 hours later, so if you cooked within 24 hours, definitely it's davar asur, right? Definitely it's davar asur because the taste comes up to the food you're going to cook right now. But 24 hours later, after that, would still be asur of the reason we're just saying right now, because since there was basar b'chalav in there, it would be asur always, even afterwards, and you'll need to do a galah before you use it. Okay? Any more questions?
What about if it's the meat is betel b'shishim?
Okay, so we'll get to bitul b'shishim. Bitul b'shishim always works, and it's not going to be asur. Not allowed to do it l'chatchila, and mevadlim isur l'chatchila, we'll see when we get to it.
So what is shur to cook batel b'chalav?
I'm sorry? Yeah, everything by accident. By accident.
What is shiur to cook basar b'chalav? What is shiur?
Yeah, basar b'chalav is asur not only, is a good question. Would you say that basar b'chalav is asur only if you have a certain shiur, a certain amount, let's say kazait? The isur is whether you have kazait or you have less than kazait, the isur of basar b'chalav applies regardless. There's no shiur to basar b'chalav. Any amount of basar b'chalav would be asur. There is a Gemara in Kufchet Amud Bet that says that shiur basar v'chalav shem vashlam beyachad loke. How much would you get malkot for over there? If you have a kazait, you would get malkot. But as you know, that even if you have something that the shiur of it kazait, if you take a crumb out of it, is also asur. Why? Because chatzi shiur asur min haTorah. It's machloket Rish Lakish and Rabbi Yochanan in the beginning of Perek Tshi'i of Yuma, Yom HaKippurim, and we posek like Rabbi Yochanan that chatzi shiur asur min haTorah, which means even if you take a crumb, chatzi shiur doesn't mean half the amount of kazait, half a kazait. It means even a crumb. You take a crumb of basar b'chalav or any other isur, and you swallow it, you violate the isur deoraita. The only difference between kazait and less than kazait is the punishment. Before you eat kazait, you don't get malkot. If you ate kazait, you get malkot for it. That's the only difference. There's a machloket in the Gemara over there. What is the reason that it's asur? Either because if you have less than shiur, it's chazili, it's tarufe. You could be metzaref to that more, and therefore the Torah forbids it, which means if you add the crumb of basar b'chalav or any other isur, since you can add to it more and more and more until it reaches kazait, so the Torah says don't even eat that little bit. That chatzi shiur, half the amount. That's one reason. Another reason that's brought down in the Gemara is that it says kol chelev lo tochelu. What's kol? What's the lashon kol? Kol to be merabe afilu chatzi shiur. There's a big machloket in the achronim. Would you say that the isur of chatzi kazait applies also to mitzvah aseh? Over there it's not a isur, it's a mitzvah. Would you say there's a aseh on chatzi shiur? Let's say you want to eat chatzi matzah. It's a chatzi matzah. Would you say that you make a mitzvah, although you complete the mitzvah only by kazait? But let's say one doesn't have a kazait. You will only have a chatzi kazait. Machloket, the Chida brings down, and the Mishneh Lamelech. Take a look at the Or Letzion in Chelek Aleph on that sugya. He says that there is a mitzvah to eat chatzi matzah, although you're not eating the full matzah. But if you only have chatzi matzah, let's say, that's the only thing you have. Should you eat it, or it's a waste of time? He says that there is a mitzvah of chatzi shiur as well, and therefore one should eat it. Okay, so that would be the answer to this question. Let's see the halakha over here. What the halakha tells us. The halakha right away in the beginning, we learned it last time, Seif Aleph, in Siman Pei Zayin, כתוב בתורה לא תבשל גדי בחלב אמו שלוש פעמים, אחד לאיסור בישול, אחד לאיסור אכילה, ואחד לאיסור הנאה. That is the reason that the Torah writes it three times. Sometimes you would find that the Torah repeats itself, and usually you learn that the reason the Torah repeats itself is to add lavim, just like we say by bugs. The Torah repeats itself in order to add lavim. Over here, the Torah didn't add lavim, rather, the Torah separated to different cases. One that you would eat, one that you would benefit, another one that you would cook. ואחד איסור הנאה. והוציא אכילה בלשון בישול לומר שאינו אסור מן התורה אלא דרך בישול. So the reason the Torah used the words לא תבשל גדי בחלב אמו, each word over here would have a limud in Chazal that we'll see in the halacha. The bishul, why does he say לא תבשל? To teach you that needs to be דרך בישול. It needs to be the normal way of cooking, and therefore some things would not be considered cooking, like for instance, if you are salting, or for instance, if you are putting the meat within the milk and you're just soaking it there, so that's called kavush. That is not asur mideoraita, because it's not derech bishul. Although kavush kemevushal, but it only means that it makes the same effect as mevushal, but not that it has the same process that you would call bishul. אבל מדרבנן אסור בכל עניין. חכמים restricted everything, and you can't do any of that, and you can't eat any of that. Doing, we'll see. Not necessarily not allowed to do, but eating any way it got combined together, that's forbidden. מדרבנן. Now the Rama adds that כל בשר וחלב שאינו אסור מן התורה מותר בענן. That's what I said before. There's three things here. There's עשייה, you're not allowed to do it. There's אכילה, and there's הנאה. Says the Rama over here, and we see the Machloket, the Bach and the Marshal argue, the Taz and the Shach brings them down, that the Rama says that if you have such a basar b'chalav that's only asur mid-rabanan, you're allowed to benefit from it. So that means that if you have such a basar b'chalav that was done through salting, through a way that would be mutar, I'm using dafka those, other things would be a big Machloket. Like for instance, if you frying something, many say that it's considered the same as cooking. Or for instance, if you are baking something, right? So
smoking
also. Yeah, you have a list of poskim, divrei chamudot, pleitim, minchat Yaakov, prima kadim, dechida. So smoking is not cooking. That's what we're saying. Smoking.
You're not cooking it.
Smoking.
You're smoking it.
Right. Smoking not later on, yeah, later on,
no.
The Shulchan Aruch,
you're adding something.
In Seif,
you're not cooking it.
In the Shulchan Aruch,
fire,
later on,
no.
We'll see that he brings
smoke.
A Yerushalmi, if smoking is asur or mutar. He brings this down openly
boiling.
In the Shulchan Aruch, okay?
That's cooking also, right? Smoking is not cooking.
And therefore he says it's asur, the Shulchan Aruch writes, that it's asur because it's a safek d'oraita.
You cook some grill. Smoke is not hot necessarily. It's only smoky.
In Seif Vav, המאושן והמבושל וחמי דבריה אין לוקים עליו. The Gra explains over here that it is a Yerushalmi, that it's a safek if it's considered mevushal or not. And therefore, we have a safek over מאושן and also mevushal b'chametz tveria. But if we want to know about smoking, it is a safek. But you
so
have
it's the same thing from cooking like on the roof. And if it's cooking from the sun, it's not like actually cooking. I just put it over there. It's not like you can say also it's not the way of cooking.
It's like chametz tveria.
Chametz tveria. So that is something that we have also a safek. A safek, it would be asur umutar. You have the question on all this. And this is something that's brought down in Kovetz Shiurim to be a safek in cooking on the sun. Okay? But we said already, we mentioned all these names before, that the Divrei Chamudot, Prichadash, Gra, Pleti, Minchat Yaakov, all of them bring that baking would be Bishul Minatorah. הרי הם בכלל לא תבשל מהתורה. And this is how also it's brought down in the Ben Ish Chai. Okay? Others argue about that. It's argue. So these are big machlokot. If you hold it's the Rabbanan, the Rama says that it's mutar be'ana'ah. You're allowed to benefit from it. So you have such a thing. You're allowed to give it to your dog or to other dogs, or to sell it to a goy, whatever it is that we said that basar v'chalav you wouldn't allow to do, basar v'chalav midorat you wouldn't allow to do, for all the reasons we explained last time, you're not allowed to give it to your dog because you're benefiting. You're not allowed to give it to a strange dog because you're also benefiting the fact that somebody's taking it. You're happy with the fact that it's not thrown to the garbage. Not allowed to give it to a goy, you're benefiting from that. So, if it's asur midorabanan and mutar min haTorah, we would permit such a thing. That's the way the Rama writes over here. You see the Rama in the end of the page. Kol basar v'chalav sheno min haTorah, mutar bana. The Taz bring on the side, marshal cholek al ze, ve'al ma shekatav haRambam, ve'amorchi misvara lachmir bana. Ve'anu en lanu ela divrei harishonim ve'achronim. So he brings over here right away the marshal. The Shach also brings in Seif Katan Bet. Tur ואיסור ואתר וכן דעת המחבר דבשר עוף בחלב שאינו אסור באכילה אלא מדרבנן מותר בהנאה אף מדרבנן, which means if you have בשר עוף בחלב, what would be chicken with milk? Is that דאורייתא or דרבנן? We פוסק that it's only דרבנן, it's אסור מדרבנן. So therefore, if you have such things that are chicken with milk, you'll be able to benefit from it. And he brings over here also as well the marshal. You're not allowed to bring it. The lo kemo shekatav habach, the dat haRambam mitzvah basar of bechalav asur be'ana'ah midrabanan, he argues on that. Okay, this is Seif Aleph. Basically, we summarize Seif Aleph. Let's go to Seif Bet. Now, we said that each word over here is nidrash. What is the word gdi comes to teach us? Would you say basar bechalav is only gdi? Because it says, otevashel gdi bechalev imo. So only a baby goat would be asur. It says over here in the Shulchan Aruch, Gdi lav davka, du adin shor se ve'ez veloshna. Yeah, oh, okay, so first thing, don't think it's only a baby goat. Any kind of meat would be asur. So whether using an ox, a cow, a sheep, or a lamb, or a goat, all of them would be asur mideoraita. What about milk? It says that so maybe only if the goat is cooked within his mother's milk, it's asur, but if it's cooked with another milk, it would be mutar. Says the Shulchan Aruch, loshna bechalav em, loshna bechalav acheret, ela shetiber hakatuv be'ove. It doesn't make a difference which milk you're using, they're all asur midoraita. So why is it that the Torah says lo tevashel gdi, baby goat, and it says b'chalev imo, only the milk of its mother? Those two things, says the Shulchan Aruch, diber hakatuv behove. The Torah just spoke on the normal circumstance, which means this was a very common thing that people that would have a goat in their farm, they would have a lot of babies, and when they have babies, they have extra milk, they have a lot of milk. So naturally, if you have a baby goat and you're hungry today and you want to eat, so you would take the milk from the goat and you would take the baby goat that was just born and you would cook it in that milk. This is how they used to do it. Now, if the Rashbam brings down such an idea that there's a lot of milk from the goat, because it says in the Pasuk in Mishlei, V'dechalav izim lelachmecha. There's a lot of milk from the goat lelachmecha, to your food. Also, the Prisha says that when the goats give birth, it has a lot of milk. So therefore, naturally, people would use that milk to cook their food, to cook their meat. And the Torah says, the Torah talks bederech haoveh. Since that's the way it was, that's the way the Torah talks. But in reality, the Torah forbids everything. Every milk, and every kind of meat.
So, what about milk from non-kosher animals?
Oh, that's the next if. We'll see when you get to Gimel.
What?
So non-kosher animals. Where do we see exactly that animal they also meant all the other animals?
Oh, animal. So that's... That's a limud in the Gemara. You go into this and you'll see, you can open over here the tour, you'll see he brings down the limud from the Gemara. He says here. We don't have the tour here.
No, I don't have it.
Yeah.
Okay. He doesn't bring it here. He doesn't bring it here. You go into the Gemara and you see inside. Okay? Thank you. So give it back to him, please. Okay. So this is Seif Bet. Let's go to Seif Gimel that has much more halakhot that's relevant to us. Eno noeg ela bebasar behema teora bechalav behema teora. The only time it would be asur is if you're using meat from a tahor animal. Animal means behema, not chaya. Bechalav behema teora. You have to use the milk from a behema tmea. Aval, basar teora bechalav tmea. If you're using meat from a kosher behema, and you're using milk from a non-kosher animal, or the opposite, basar tmea, that the meat is from a non-kosher animal, but the milk is from kosher. So it says here that it's mutarim bebishul uveana. You're allowed to cook it, and you're allowed to benefit from it. Because we said that anything that's asur only mide rabbanan, you're only not allowed to eat it, but to cook in it, or to benefit from it, would be mutal. Now, over here, there's a question that you probably want to ask. How could you say it's only asur mide rabbanan to eat? We're talking about basar tmea. Basar tmea is taref. How could you eat something that's basar tmea? By the way, the term taref doesn't go on that, but right, we explained. Taref means something else, that it has a certain sickness. But over here, it's called the basar behema tmea. So you have something that's tameh, let's say you have a pig, right? And you cooked it in kosher milk. So that's asur, it says over here, mide rabbanan. That's how the two brings down. Oh, so and the shach and the taz ask the question, how could you tell me it's the rabbanan? Maybe the milk and meat are the rabbanan, but the meat itself has a different isur, that's a isur Torah. You're not allowed to eat the pig meat. That's what it is, right? They bring over here different perushim, how to learn it, either because of Hanan. I don't want to learn those things right now. We're going to learn about those terms later on. But this is a question that Taz and the Shach has. So he brings down over here the Shulchan Aruch and says, basar chaya ve'of afilu bechalav teora mutar bebishul uvena'ana. Open Shulchan Aruch that whether you have a chaya or you have an off chicken, you're allowed mideoraita to cook them with milk and to eat them with milk. And miderabanan, it would be asur only to eat them, but it would be allowed to cook them and to benefit from it. Ve'af be'achila eno asur, ela miderabanan. Eating them would be asur only miderabanan, aval dagim v'chagavim en bahem isur ela miderabanan. If you want to eat fish or grasshoppers in milk, that's mutar even miderabanan. Now one might ask the question, you're allowed to eat fish together with milk? We don't need fish together with milk, right? Ashkenazim do, but we don't, right?
Because it's wrong, because it's not...
So over here, the Rama in Darkei Moshe, and over here it's also mentioned in the Taz and the Shach, that in the Bet Yosef it's brought down that one is not allowed to eat fish together with milk. What's the reason? Because of sakana. Just like we found meat and fish are not allowed, Chazal tell us that's asur meat because there's a sakana, and that is brought down sakana of tzarat. Would you say that the same thing applies to milk and fish? So the Bet Yosef writes it does. And therefore, from there became the minhag not to eat fish together with milk. But the Rama in Darkei Moshe says that this is a mistake in the Beit Yosef. He says, itarev lo basar bechalav, which means really what the Beit Yosef meant to say, that it's asur fish with meat, not fish with milk.
Ah,
but the Shulchan Aruch made over here itarev lo. It was a mixture over here of meat and milk. Now what it means probably is that the printer has made a mistake over here.
Exactly.
That's where the Darkei Moshe brings down. And this is how the Shach and the Taz bring down over here. But many of the Sfaradi Poskim learn it just the way the Beit Yosef says it, and they bring it halakha lemaaseh, including the Beit Lechem Yehuda, the Atnei Paz, the Shiurei Knesset Agdola, Chinuch Beit Yehuda, and many bring this down, in the Rishonim you find such a thing. Who brings from the Rishonim? Rabbeinu Bechaye says. Rabbeinu Bechaye, which called Varav Divrei Kabbalah, writes the following. That you'll find in Rabbeinu Bechaye, in Shemot Kaf Gimel, Pasuk Yutet. He writes, Ken da'at arofim betarovet dag ve'gvina shenitbashlu ke'echad. The doctors testify that fish and milk together, molit chuna ra v'chol yatzarat, will bring you bad character traits, and will bring you lo alenu leprosy, tzarat. So this brought down already in Rabbeinu Bechaye. So you find this in the Stechemed as well, and many of the Sfaradi poskim bring this down halacha lemaaseh. Chacham Ovadia brings this down halacha lemaaseh. What's the halacha? What's the halacha? Those that have a minhag to be mekel, many have minhag to be mekel, can continue doing so, just like the Ashkenazim do so. The Yad Yehuda writes something very, very simple. He says that since Chazal didn't say it's a sakana, unlike they spoke about fish and meat together, that over there, they clearly said it's a sakana, one needs to be careful, and he's not allowed to eat it. It's even, Chazal calls such things, chamira sakanta meisura, sakana is worse than eating something that's forbidden, and so much that the Taz says that it's not batel afilu be'elef, which means if you have drop of meat or drop of milk falling into your meat soup, over there all you need is 60. Taz says that if you had a drop of fish fall into your meat soup, you can't allow it whatsoever, even if you have 60, even if you have 1,000. We're not posek like the Taz. You take a look in Kufta Zayin, but he brings such an opinion down. So you'll have to take it seriously, right? But the Eved will be Mekel, but it gives you some kind of idea how serious this thing is. So, Guf the Zayin Sif Bet, צריך להיזהר שלא לאכול בשר ודג ביחד, מפני שקשה לצרת. This is how the Shulchan Aruch writes, and you take a look over here at the Taz. But the Pitchei Tshuva brings many prings to argue on the Taz that it should be batel b'shishim as well, and you don't have anything left. Yeah.
So should I get rid of the cream cheese or the lox?
How can you testify? How can you use the doctors testifying that it's bad? You know that it's good, or it's
just
bad
the bagels
for your character traits. Why is he using the doctors as an example?
good question. But let me just tell you what the Yad Yehuda writes. He writes the Yad Yehuda that since it's not written in the Gemara, so therefore, if you see that it changes today, so you go according to today, way things are. Many things we found that Tvaim Nishtanu, nature have changed. The Magen Avraham brings such as it, Tosfot brings it as a Gemara in Beitza. The Gemara says that rotten fish is healthy. Today, says Tosfot, it's not true. Rotten fish can't have anything less, more not healthy than rotten fish, right? It's very dangerous.
Really?
So, but that's how the Gemara writes. So the Tosfot writes that Tvaim Nishtanu, Magen Avraham, this down also. In Halakha, you have the same idea, let's say, by Maim Achronim, that by Melach Sdomit, that he would bring that today doesn't apply, although we do Maim Achronim, but there is such a concept. So over here also, and much more, that the Yad Yehuda brings, that this is something that's not written in the Gemara any place, so therefore you could allow such a thing. Since today is very, you see that it changed. Something that would be also relevant to this question would be, what about butter? Butter in with meat. would you say that the isur is only milk and meat, or also butter? Ben Ishchai was machmir with butter as well. He writes that it's the same thing, and this is how the Kaf HaChaim brings down. Cream cheese, cheese is definitely milk. It's milk for everything. But the way butter is made is different than cream cheese. They use the fat, the milk fat, and they make from there, they process it and they make the butter, which means it's already a stage less than milk. We're going to see such a concept soon in Siman Pei Zayin, later on in this Siman, that there's two things. There's Nisiu V'dechalva and there's Mei Chalav. Nisiu V'dechalva means you take the cheese, and when you make the cheese, you harden the cheese, the milk comes down. This is called Nisiu V'dechalva. This is still Asur Mishum Basar V'chalav. But then, the whey. And then when you take that and you process it again, the milk that comes out, the water that comes out from that Nisiu V'dechalva is called Mei Chalav. That's already not Asur Mishum Basar B'chalav. So same idea with the butter, it's a stage less that many poskim would allow. Halakha lemaaseh, this is how you would find in Adnei Paz, this is how you find also in Bet Lechem Yehuda. Again, you'll find that the Ben Ishchai and the Kaf HaChaim argue on that. I think the rabbi of the Ben Ishchai, Rav Abdallah Somech, he writes, right, in Zifrei Tzedek, he writes that it is mutar. So you have a machloket over butter. Chacham Ovadia allows it, if you want to know his opinion, okay?
Butter and fish.
Okay, not butter with milk, chas v'shalom. That definitely should be a soup. Okay?
Butter with milk?
Meat.
Meat. No butter with meat? No. Okay. Butter with fish? That is the machloket. So what are we saying over here? What are we saying over here? Dagim v'chagavim en bayim isur afilu midrabanan. By the way, the grasshoppers today is a big controversy also, if you can allow, because do we have a Mesorah or we don't have a Mesorah? That is the question. The Yemens have a Mesorah. Some Moroccans had a Mesorah. Ashkenazim definitely don't have a Mesorah. And there is a discussion over that, if you can allow for others to rely on their Mesorah, right? Let's say a Yemen comes and he tells you, we ate this in Yemen. This is what we ate. So, right? This, I remember this exact grasshoppers looking exactly like this. We ate in Sana'a. So now, would you say that since he has a Mesorah and he testifies on this, you can eat it or no? Chacham Ovadia has the same discussion over the turkey. Turkey also, today they have the same machloket as well with the new chicken that they found in Israel. You heard about this? A new chicken they brought to Israel. And some poskim said that is the real chicken. That is the chicken. For instance, Rav Mutzafi writes like this. He recently said like that. That they say that this is the Rav Klein said like that. The Talmid of the Shevet Alevi. This is the real chicken. Mimele comes out. That could be the chicken we're eating today. Is that the real chicken? And you have many poskim that say the opposite. Rav Landau, Rav Wansofer say that this chicken is not kosher. Big machloket right now. Controversy that goes on today, on daily basis in Israel. But when we're talking about the turkey, there was the same big machloket over the turkey, kosher, not kosher. What's the machloket? Machloket, do we have a Mesorah? The Rama writes that all of those things have to have a Mesorah, which means you know that this is what my father ate and this is what my mother cooked and put it on the table. If you don't have a Mesorah, you can't eat it. That's what he writes over here. Although it has a simanim, you don't rely just on the simanim. So Chacham Ovadia brings such an opinion that although some don't have a Mesorah, but they can rely on those that do have a Mesorah. Would we say it over here, or we don't take it all the way by grasshoppers? That's another question, yeah.
So, I didn't get an answer to the previous question about relying on the rabbi, on the doctors.
Oh, so but he wants to ask, how could you rely on the doctors for bad character traits? We said over here that that the Ben Ishchai says molid tchuna ra'a, it creates with you bad character traits. Now it could be that they don't mean necessarily tchuna as a character trait. It could be that they mean something else over here, something more physical. But even if it's not like that, doctors don't necessarily mean that you're a pediatrician, right? It means that anybody that's in the field, whether it's a field a psychiatry or a psychology or whatever it is, it's all go. So they would tell you this, stay away. Do they also have such thing? They tell you, you know what? Don't stay away from certain food that they make the kids hyper, right? Don't give candies. Candies make kids hyper. You try it on your kid, you'll see.
Sugar.
He starts sugar. He starts jumping much more. He'll get depressed, right? People eat sugar, they get depressed. So they tell you, listen, stay away from that.
How long ago was it said?
This Rabbeinu Bechai is the Rishon. We're talking about 900 years ago. So we have some very, very strong over here testimony from Rabbeinu Bechai. So therefore, those that have the minhag not to eat fish and milk, definitely bring it from correct sources and should not change that. Okay?
And about the Mesorah. So we have the simanim. Why can't we just rely on the simanim?
Right, because we don't know for sure that it fits what we should be mutar. We can't rely for sure on those simanim because we don't trust ourselves that those fit exactly those simanim that Chazal told us. They offer certain things that we still have shaking. Yeah.
According to what we learn right now, you can be lenient with milk and fish, but we have to be very strict with milk and meat, with fish and meat, right?
Right.
How come that's not the case? Most people are almost never strict.
On fish and meat?
Yeah.
People are very strict. Nobody eats fish and milk. And fish and meat.
We don't
fish
eat it together.
One after the other, it's fine. You eat the fish. Ben Ishchai brings the Rabbi Kiva Iger brings Guftet Zayin brought down over here in Rabbi Kiva Iger that you should have some kind of liquor in between. Shechar. Right? Some kind of Yain Saraf. So people take some kind of schnapps in between. The Hasidim are very makpid on this. And then you could eat your meat, right? And you have to do maimim tzayim, you have to clean your hands, and you have to clean your mouth. And
so
then
you
and this is halacha in Shulchan Aruch, by the way. It's brought down in the Shulchan Aruch, those things. Let's see inside. Yilchotz yadav ben basar ledag, v'yochal pat sharui ben taim, kedei lilchotz piv. So this is the Shulchan Aruch, that you should wash your hands in between. And you should eat something in between the fish and the meat.
Can you use the same forks?
Oh, so can you use the utensils that you use, let's say, to cook fish? You want to cook now meat, or vice versa? We'll see in Tzadik Hei, the Shulchan Aruch says an interesting lashon. The Shulchan Aruch, when he speaks right away about the idea of nat bar nat, he uses that it should be mutar to eat that fish. It says the gimshen itbashlu nitzlu bekdera shel basar. If you have fish that was cooked in meat utensils that was completely clean, so then it would be allowed bishum nat barnat. Over here, if you take a look at the shach, not necessarily would allow it, the shach and the taz, but lemaase the achronim write that the minhag is to use the same utensils without any problem, which means you have something that's considered fleshic, meat utensils, you want to cook right now fish, even ben yomo, even if you just cooked meat in it, you clean it very well, the minhag that the achronim bring down is to allow you to use the same utensils for fish and vice versa as well. You might ask, do you need also utensils for palv? Many people have meat utensils, fish, dairy utensils, and pav utensils. We don't find in halakha that you need to have dairy utensils. You want to cook something pav? You don't need pav utensils. You want to cook something pav? You don't need to have special kelim for that. Only the marshal was machmir, and some went with his psak, but lemaaseh, you don't need to. So this gives you an idea large, what would be mutar.
Pasta,
you can do any pot. The question is, let's say you're making pasta on a meat pot, and now you want to put on the pasta cheese, that becomes a little bit problematic. We'll go into the question of nat bar nat, when it's mutar, when it's asur, that's later on.
But Hamavadia posek that it's like katchila, it's fine.
That's right, Hamavadia is matir. Hamavadia and Shema Shlomo, Rav Shlomo Amar, also matir, but almost across the board, the poskim don't allow to do it lechatchila. only if it was done according to Sfaradim, you can put it together. According to Ashkenazim, you can't even put it together. You take a look in the beginning of Tzadik Hei, but you're right. Chacham Ovadia was matir. Beis is matir to do nat barnat lechatchila, which means you want to take pasta and you have a meat utensil that you just use for meat within 24 hours, because if you didn't, then the whole question of nat barnat doesn't start. If it's 24 hours that you, since you used it, so then it's mutar, only the marshal is machmir, tzadik hei that does brings him down. But otherwise, it's mutar according to others to take that and to cook it in there and mix it together with cheese. But what's the question? The question is, can you take that utensil that you just used for meat within 24 hours and you clean it well, you cook pasta when you know you want to put cheese on top of that pasta? Can you do such a thing? The halacha seems to indicate that you're not allowed to do it from the lashon of the Shulchan Aruch that says lashon of bedieved in tzadik hei seif aleph. It says over there a lashon that seems to be bedieved, not lechatchila. And this is how it is in the Taz and the Shach, and this is how you find it is in the Beit Yosef as well. But we do find that the Beit Yosef contradicts himself, because the Beit Yosef, he wrote also that such a thing would be lechatchila as well. So therefore, we have over here a contradiction. What would you do? Would you say that it's mutar? Would you say that it's asur? Chacham Ovadia went with the psak that it's mutar lechatchila. That's how he wanted to go. So, and he tries to find it also support from different places. But across the board, almost all the poskim don't agree with that mahalach, and they learn that you're not allowed to do such a thing lechatchila. So therefore, if one wants to rely on Chacham Ovadia, fine, but it's much better not to use and do such a thing lechatchila.
What about food that was cooked with meat? Let's say, for example, rice. And you had meat and I ate only from
together
the
with meat.
Yes.
So you want to take only the rice, that will find in Siman Peitet, another two simanim. That's called Tavshil Shel Basar. You're right. Tavshil Shel Basar, according to Shulchan Aruch, would not. You eat only the rice, you eat only the potatoes. Would not make you meat, would not make you fleshy, you don't have to wait 6 hours. But the Rama argues over there, and the Kafachaim writes that the minhag of the Sfaradim today is also like the Ashkenazim, and therefore if you take the rice alone and you eat them, you eat the rice, or you take the potatoes only and you eat the potatoes, although you ate only davar that's considered tafshit shel basar, you would have to wait 6 hours according to the minhag.
Because that's our minhag.
So we wait 6 hours.
We do it.
Can I say, okay, I don't want to do it because, you know, I'm going by the Shulchan Aruch?
No, because the Shulchan Aruch himself writes that everything in the Beit Yosef, in the Akdamah, he writes that all the psakim that he writes in the Shulchan Aruch is only if there's no other minhagim. But there is a minhag, you have to follow the minhag. You take a look at Resh Yud Dalet, Siman Resh Yud Dalet in Shulchan Aruch, and you'll see in Yoredea, and he writes over there that the minhag that was accepted, you can't break. You can do whatever you want.
He had before him, and not after him, that it was accepted.
True, but that's what he says. But the halacha and the idea would apply to any minhag, even if started afterwards. Chida writes that the minhag has to be established by rabbis, by somebody that has some kind of credit. But if you have some people that starting something, so not necessarily it has a din of minhag. Chacham Ovadia calls it minhag otiyot geenom. So that is when a minhag is a minhag betaut.
What is the Ben Ish Chai opinion about food?
I think it's pretty much accepted.
Also 6 hours?
On this matter?
I'm
telling you, it's a Kafachaim. Kafachaim is a Talmid of the Ben Ish Chai. So the Ben Ish Chai doesn't write it, but the Kafachaim writes that this is the minhag, so I would pretty much trust that he would agree to that as well.
Sorry, I have a very elementary question.
Oh.
Very simple question.
Yes.
It says, where does it say that it
is
6 hours?
That's a good question. So we're going to have to speak about that. We're coming up to that.
Okay.
But we'll have to speak about that in length. I can't answer you that on al regel achat.
I think my minhag is 3 hours.
3 hours, yeah? Were you from Holland?
No, because they eat every 3 hours.
Where are you from?
No, I'm
Bukhari. Oh,
where do you get the minhag from?
Because our food has to wait 12 hours.
From meal to meal, you eat every 2 hours.
No, like in Greenland, they eat every 2 hours.
Hadish, anyone? Hadish, anybody? No?
Hadish, Hananiah.
We learned something.
Zagor.